At the Battle of Hyporee, roughly 4 months after the First Battle of Geonosis and the start of the Clone War, the cyborg General Grievous revealed himself for the first time to the Republic and the Jedi. From that point on, the Republic recognized Grievous as the Supreme Commander of the Separatist Droid Army, a position he would hold until his demise in the final days of the war. However, as impressive as Grievous was, he was not the first choice of the Sith Lords Sidious and Dooku to command the Separatist forces. That position was initially held by a little-known Chiss female named Sev'rance Tann. In this video expose, I will describe who Sev'rance Tann was, and how she ultimately came to rise to prominence not only as Dooku's most important dark acolyte, but also as a Separatist general who held more authority than Grievous in the first month of the Clone War. Born on the planet of Scylla within Chiss Base, located within the Unknown Regions, Sev'rance Tann was one of only a very few Chiss who was known to be Force-sensitive. But Tann's abilities that would be best utilized in the Clone War were a result not just of her connection to the Force, but also her mind for military strategy and tactics. In the final years of the Galactic Republic, Tann attended the Chiss Academy, resulting in her adopting a significant understanding of military strategy and tactical knowledge, abilities that would be made even greater due to her Force sensitivity. However, Tann's talents would be utilized not by the Chiss within the Unknown Regions, but rather by Darth Sidious and the Sith plan to destroy the Republic and Jedi. In the waning days of peace, prior to the start of the galactic conflict, defined by the Separatist Crisis, Tann was brought to Republic space by Sidious, and joined Dooku as one of his dark acolytes. The reason for how and why the Chiss female was made known to the Sith would become a topic heavily debated by galactic historians. Many ultimately speculated that it was Thrawn, a Chiss Expansionary Defense Force officer at the time, who brought Tann to Sidious' attention, with Thrawn having met the Dark Lord of the Sith roughly 5 years earlier. Having joined Dooku, Tann began her study of the dark side and lightsaber combat. Even before her first engagements within the Clone War, Tann already caught the attention of Dooku, gaining his trust fully and becoming the leader of his dark side acolytes. With Dooku having traveled to Geonosis and having foreseen the battle that would ultimately become known as the First Battle of Geonosis igniting there, the Sith Lord contacted Tann and ordered his acolyte to travel to the planet to assist with what would become his forthcoming escape. As Dooku's vision would unfold, the Chiss General became invaluable in helping him flee Geonosis, destroying the Republic forces that aimed to impede Dooku's escape from the battlefield, and even striking down a Jedi Padawan with her lightsaber. Pleased with her efforts on Geonosis, and having escaped the enormous battle there herself, the Sith Lord rewarded Tann by allowing her to oversee the production of her own droid army on the Kerr orbital platform within the Outer Rim. Although the Republic would ultimately find her production base, Tann successfully fled with her new army at her side, ready to execute the next stage of Dooku's plan. Tann was then sent to the Outer Rim planet of Tatooine, where the Chiss General successfully attacked a Republic trading outpost and spaceport, besting the Republic forces comprising not only of clone troopers, but Jedi as well. To add to Tann's military victory, she also learned of a secret weapon being developed by the Republic known as the Decimator. Upon learning of this weapon, Dooku ordered Tann to depart for the Midrim planet of Alaris Prime, a Wookiee colony world where the Republic was manufacturing the secret weapon. Ultimately, Tann destroyed the Republic defenses guarding the Decimator facilities, and her forces decrypted the weapon's operational codes, now placing the ability to use and manufacture the secret weapon for themselves. As great as these successes were, Tann's next attack as demanded by Dooku not only saw her rise to prominence within the view of the Separatist Council and the Sith, but also pushed the Republic to the brink of defeat. Dooku's next phase of his plan called for Tann to target the volcanic, remote world of Serapin, located in the heart of the Republic within the Galactic Core. Serapin was of central importance to the Republic, as it generated enough energy to provide the core worlds with 80% of their power, including the Republic capital world of Coruscant. Because of its importance, Serapin was one of the most fortified and heavily defended planets in the entire galaxy, prompting Dooku to turn to his most trusted and favored general, Sev'rance Tann. To carry out Dooku's invasion orders, Tann assembled an elite task force. Having first succeeded in destroying the shield surrounding the planet, she then ordered an invasion of Serapin and a strike against the Republic base located there. Tann's strike against the primary base could not have been more impressive, as she ultimately succeeded in not just destroying the Republic forces waiting for her planet side, but also defended the planet against Republic reinforcements sent to regain Serapin. In the Republic counterattack, Tann was able to slay another Jedi, this time a Jedi Knight named Jor Drakkus. With Serapin now under Separatist control, dozens of Republic worlds located within the galactic core descended into darkness. Not even the capital planet of Coruscant could prevent some of its regions from being affected by the loss of power. Tann's victory, still only in the opening weeks of the war, caused panic to spread across the core worlds, causing many Republic senators to grow increasingly worried about the direction of the galactic conflict. Following her assault of Serapin, Sev'rance Tann vaulted herself to the top of the Separatist hierarchy, obtaining more clout and authority than any other Separatist general in the war, including the Separatist cyborg Grievous. Perhaps more importantly, Tann became one of Dooku's most valuable assets, solidifying her position as leader of Dooku's Dark Acolytes. Unfortunately for Tann and the Separatists, their hold of Serapin would not be a lengthy one. Her success on the fortified core world led to the direct intervention of the Jedi High Council, who concluded that Tann was a danger that had to be stopped as quickly as possible. To assassinate the Chiss general, the Jedi eventually tracked her to the Midrim planet of Krant, wherein Jedi Master Ichu Shenzhen and his Padawan Nat Reeth, the master and sister of the Padawan Tann killed on Geonosis, were sent directly to confront and kill her. Ultimately, Tann was confronted by the Jedi Master after he'd fallen to the dark side. Calling upon the power of the dark side, Shenzhen struck Tann down, as a single sweep of his lightsaber cut her in half. With her dying words, Tann confidently told the Jedi Master that the war would result in the annihilation of the Jedi. Although Shenzhen chose to flee into the wilderness, his Padawan survived to inform the High Council that one of their most dangerous foes had fallen. Despite only surviving 1 month into the Clone War, Tann left a significant impact on the early stages of the war. For Dooku in particular, Tann's demise was a serious setback, forcing him to promote Grievous as the Supreme Commander of the Droid Army and Asajj Ventress as leader of his Dark Acolytes. So there we have it, the rise and fall of Sev'rance Tann in the earliest days of the Clone War. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. Or perhaps follow us on Twitter, @SWReadingClub, for updates regarding the channel. Or support the channel through Patreon, for access to exclusive hangouts and book discussions. If not for me... for Force-sensitive female Thrawns.